This week, Fujifilm released brand new software that will allow your Fujifilm X camera to connect directly into your computer as a webcam. No other hardware needed. You don't need one of these cam links. You don't need anything but the Fujifilm camera and the software. I'm going to demo this for you and show you how to get it going. Let's get into it. Hi everyone and welcome to Pal to Tech. I had made a video previously showing you how to connect a Fujifilm camera as a webcam using the Elgato Cam Link capture device. You know, that works just fine, but the problem is that these devices are so expensive right now. There's so much price gouging going on, and other camera manufacturers have really stepped up their game in providing integrated software and apps to allow their cameras to be used as webcams. Well, now Fujifilm has stepped into the ring, and you should know that you no longer need a Cam Link device to use your Fujifilm camera as a webcam. A couple of important points about this software. First off, it's brand new, and it was released just this week. I'm sure there's going to be some bugs and wrinkles that have to be ironed out. Right now, as of this video, the software is version 1.0. Second, it doesn't support all Fujifilm cameras. Here's a list of the cameras that the software currently supports as of the date of this video. And third, and probably the most problematic, it only works on PCs running Windows. There's no version for Mac. Now, I would assume that they're working on one right now, but as of the date of this video, Windows only. So I'm gonna demo the entire thing for you, show you the settings, everything 100%. First off, you need a Fujifilm X camera that's supported on the list. I'm gonna use the X-T2 camera. I also have the battery grip on here plugged into the wall, so I have unlimited power. The second thing you need is to go into the camera's settings, go into power management, and make sure that auto power off is set to off. You don't want this thing just shutting off in the middle of your webcast. Now, I normally use Macs for a lot of photo editing and video applications, but I do use PCs, and for this demo, I'm gonna use this ancient IBM ThinkPad. It weighs about as much as a Winnebago. It's huge, okay? Right? And check this out. Look at this power strip here. This thing is huge. This is the size of like that new Sony camera that shoots 4K. This thing is bigger and heavier. Can you imagine carrying this thing around on an airplane and going all over the place with it? I did. In terms of software on here, it is a Windows 10 installation. That's what I have. You can freeze this frame and look at these specs if you want. So that's what we're going to demo with right now. So the first thing we want to do is go to the Fujifilm X webcam software download page. I will, of course, have a link to that down in the description of this video. Go ahead and download. Once you download it, you'll see it as a zip file. Go ahead and open it up. I'm gonna choose English, click on Fujifilm X webcam, and that's gonna ask if you wanna run it, obviously. Go ahead and install it. And it's going to require the computer to restart. Okay, now that your computer is back on after the restart, it should be a simple matter of connecting a USB cord to the Fujifilm camera and then connecting that into your computer. Back in the days when they actually put ports on computers. Have a look at this. Look at all these ports. Anything you could possibly ever want. Boom, right there it is. Plugged it in. Okay, let's see. Oh, look at that. Have a look at that. X-T2, select choose what happens with this device. Let's see here. Wow, okay, I don't know what I'm supposed to do here when I plug it in. Let's see. I am just gonna say, take no action. It didn't say in the instructions what I'm supposed to do, so let's see if it works. I'm gonna open up Zoom now to try and do a Zoom meeting, and let's see if this thing connects and recognizes this as a Fujifilm X camera. Okay, I'm in the Zoom settings right now. Video, which is where you would go. Okay, so I am seeing myself through the integrated camera that's on this laptop. We don't want that. We wanna use the Fujifilm camera. So generally, whether it's Zoom or whether it's Skype, you should be able to select your video source. In this case, have a look at this, Fuji X webcam, boom. Oh my goodness, it worked. Have a look at this. Whoa, and make sure if you're in Zoom that you tick the box that says enable HD as well. Okay, Oh, I'm digging this. I am really digging this. Oh, wow. Isn't it great doing this channel? I get to play with these toys, all right? This is like I come to work, I get to play with toys and find and check out new stuff and then tell you if it works or not. This is the dream job for me. This is perfect. Hi, everybody, and welcome to Pal to Tech. Let's try that. Okay, so this is working really well. On the front, I can zoom in. Look at that. Have a look. Right? I can zoom in. Now let's talk about audio. You would think that it would work with the microphone on the Fujifilm camera. Let's check that out. If you go into your audio settings, I can choose the audio device that's on the laptop, as you can see right here. That's the one that's built into the laptop. Okay, so with regard to audio, from what I can see here, you cannot use the built-in microphone on the Fujifilm camera. And what that tells me is you cannot plug another external mic, like one of these external microphones, into the camera and expect that to work. You're gonna have to either use the built-in mic on your computer, or you could plug an external microphone into the computer as an additional audio device, and then when you go into your webcam software like Zoom or Skype, select that. You should have, you know, a little lav mic. I'll have a link to one in the description below, a little USB lav mic that you can plug into the computer and then have right here, and it'll sound great for the best audio. But that also begs the question is, what about latency, right? You know what I'm talking about, where it doesn't match? Well, that all depends on a lot of factors. It depends on the speed of your computer. It depends on what's running in the background. Say you have Dropbox trying to sync and you've got all these programs open and 9 different Chrome browser tabs. That will slow down your computer. It has to do lots of things at once, and that could make the latency worse. It also has to do with the bit rate and a number of other factors. So really, you're just gonna need to test this out. But the great news is that this is a free software app that you can download and start using. And if you're a Windows user, these things are about $300 or so. And I did make a video on it, and I did say that yes, you can use these. And even if you have $300, these are hard to find. People are price gouging these things. Kind of sucks. Well, I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please do the like and subscribe thing. And I will see you in another video real soon. Take care. One thing I forgot to mention in the video is that how would you be able to see yourself while you're shooting? Most of the Fujifilm cameras don't have a flippy screen, right? Well, there's this cool little device right here that's basically a mirror. You stick it on top of the camera, you flip up the screen in the background, and you can see yourself really well. In fact, it also has little connectors on top that you could put a mic in case you need an external mic for whatever reason. So it's, or a light, say. So it's really cool. So you can see yourself when you're filming, and you can check the settings, right? You can go into the camera settings fairly easily. Not too shabby. I'll have a link to this down below. You can get these anywhere. They're about between $13 and $15. All right, see ya.